afternoon, everybody. Now we'll see how to debug our programs with DDD. So, what is DDD? DDD is basically for monitoring your program execution. Many times after writing a C program, you have to debug it. So, maybe it will be for C program, C++, Java. DDD provides a common interface for all these debuggers. So, it's basically a front end. It internally uses other available debuggers and gives you user friendly interface. So we can use it for debugging executable binaries, output of our GCC or G++ compiler. We can also use it for Java bytecode output, Python, Perl. Many support for many different languages is available. So how to invoke DDD? Simple command DDD. The other way is we can directly specify executable as a command line argument, or you can attach some running program to DDD. We'll see that later. First, let's start with a simple C program debugging. We'll switch to demo directly so that we can better understand it. Just start your browser, Mozilla browser, and enter this path in your browser to get a sample C program. Once you enter, it will ask you whether you want to save the file or not. Got the file? Go to the save as, file save as, and save it in the current folder, desktop folder. Just save file, don't save it as a web page, save it as a .c file only. After that, just open the file from gedit, open the terminal window if you don't have. Go to the terminal window and move to the desktop folder. By default, you'll be here. Do cd desktop and vim sample.c. So this is a normal C file for bubble sort, a simple bubble sort on array. Let's just walk through this code briefly. Go below. This is the main starting point. Arguments. Arguments passed are the all elements in array, and we want our program to sort this out. Here we are allocating an array for the elements. This loop converts the text into the numbers using function a to I. So it converts from string to integer the arguments that we have, and this is main bubble sort function. We are passing array into it and size of array, and this is simple printing. Let's just go to the bubble sort quickly. So arguments are array a and size, that is 0 to the number of element, last element in the array, and this is the simple implementation of bubble sort. So now let's compile this program and we see how it works using DDD. So just get out of Vim and compile this program using GCC -o sample.o, so that our output file will be sample.o. Now let's run this program. Arguments are the elements we pass. Yeah, so that is the bug we have to find using DDD. So as you can see, four elements we have passed are 10, 20, 10, 30, 25, and as an output we are getting 0. So we'll use now DDD to find this bug. So use DDD sample.o. One step we missed out. Whenever you want to debug any program using DDD, you have to specify option G while compiling it. So here specify GCC sample.c and hyphen G hyphen O. Hyphen G enables the generation of debug information in your executable. so that DDD can debug it. So don't miss this option, otherwise DDD will not be able to debug your program. So now we'll do DDD sample.o, and now you can see the sample.c is already open for you. So this is your source window and this is debug window. As you can see, there is a prompt GDB. So DDD internally uses the debugger known as GDB for debugging your program. So let's just run this on the GDB prompt. You can type run, oh, it has exited. Let's go for the menus first. So from the program menu, go to the program menu and select run. Now program run, so it will ask you for arguments here. Give any 4, 25 and say run. So now in the GDB prompt you will see the output, it's same as what we had earlier. Now we'll start debugging this. So first thing that we want is a program should stop initially for us. So we want it to break on the main. So click on main. This is the arguments window. It will immediately show you the text that you have selected. And then go to the break and select it. And you will see a breakpoint has been inserted on the first instruction in your function. Now again go to the program, run. Arguments are already there, last time's arguments, and choose run. So now the program has stopped on the breakpoint we have selected. Now from this point onwards we can go through stepping our program, we can monitor data values and all. So let's go step by step. So here we are allocating array. Here the green arrow indicates that your execution has stopped on this line. So let's go to the view menu and click on command tools. So you will get this window that gives you all commands for executing this program. View, command tool. Okay, so now there is a next button in this that allows you to go to the next line. So clicking on this, your execution has moved forward. The array A has been allocated using malloc. And now this for loop is extracting the text from your command line into your array A. So let's monitor contents of this array A. For that, click on A and in the window type, in your arguments window type A of 0, A into square bracket 0, at the rate bracket argc, that was the first argument to main, argc minus 1. So we are just saying it to display the contents of array A and its length is argc minus 1. Click on display and you will see array has been displayed here. This is your data window. It shows contents of the variables. So I suppose everyone is now able to see this in data window, contents of array A. So now right click on this and select rotate. So it will show your contents horizontally, you can view it in one view. It will just show it horizontally. It was being displayed vertically, it will show that horizontally. So now as you can see, contents are all zeros. Now this for loop is going to convert one by one our element, extract it into the array. Make sure you have this tool, command tool available. You can display it using view command tool. Now just click next. So it will go to the first step, and as you can see that element 20 has been extracted into array A. So we'll go on extracting every element 10, 30, 25, and it has come out of loop. So here we ensure that the arguments that we have passed on the command line are getting extracted properly. Now we'll go through this function directly, we'll go over this function. So click next and it goes to the for loop. Now just look, have a look at array contents, it is 0, 10, 20, 25. So this means this function bubble sort has some problem, it is adding 0 to our program. So we have to analyze it through. So let's finish execution of this, just click on continue. So program will run and finish. So program exited normally, and now run it again. It has stopped there. We'll go through this again. Now you can use until command so that the program will complete execution of loop and will stop on the next line. As we have already monitored how the for loop works and we know it is running correctly, we directly want to move to the next line, we'll click on until. So it has come out of that loop directly, doing all iterations in that loop. Everyone has reached here, bubble sort function. So the array contains, we have extracted arguments in array, and now we want to step into this bubble sort. Remember that when we click next, the control got to this for directly. Now we want to debug this function through. For that we have to use step. So step goes through the function. So as you can see, now the control is in this bubble function. So it has stopped on the first line in bubble. Now as you can see, this array A has disappeared from data window. This is because our stack frame has changed, we have lost reference to the variable A that was allocated by earlier function, we are on different stack frame now. You can always view the stack frames using the status backtrace. Click on status backtrace and you will see two stack frames there, this one and other one. So one is the main command, main function, and this is the second call, second stack frame. You can just see the contents of other stack frame. If you click on main, the array A reappears. So it is, the array A is valid only in that function, and in bubble sort it is not there. So now we need to monitor A that is in bubble sort's context. So let's add it again to data window. Similarly, click on A into square bracket, here in the argument window type A into square bracket 0 at the rate and specify size into the bracket and click on display. You can also add size to the display. So like this you can add as many variables you want to the data window and you can monitor their execution. Done? Everyone getting this? So now as you can see, size is 5 and array already contains 0. So there is a problem, the arguments to the function, the size argument to the function is probably missing. We have to give 4, rather we have to give argc minus 1, but we are passing argc and it's taking the last element also. Let's debug through this for loop and verify this. So command tool, we'll use next for this. So the first iteration, you can see it has swapped 10 and 20. As we know in bubble sort, in every iteration it puts highest element to the end. So again the second time, so it has swapped 25 and 30, and now let's monitor this array closely, and it has swapped 0 and 30. So that means it's treating 0 as one of the elements in array. So there is the problem. This is because the size that we have passed is wrong. So let's try to correct this and see if this works properly. Click on finish, so it will come out of loop. Finish forces it to come out of the current stack frame, that is the current function. So after clicking finish, it comes out of bubble sort directly. And as you can see, the output is 0, 10, 20, 25. So there is the problem. Let's click on continue, and now we will try to correct this problem. So run it again with the same arguments. We'll go to the bubble sort using step, and now size is 5 and our prediction is size should be 1 less than what it is. So let's try to set it here itself. We'll try to mutate it here and see if the program works fine. So we'll click on size, it is there in the argument window, and click on set. It will ask you for a value. The current value is 5. And we think that it should be actually 4. So change it to 4 and click on OK. So as you can see, the size is 4 now. We have changed it. And now let's try to run this program normally. We'll click on finish so that the function will complete. And now as you can see, the array contents are fine. So this means that the size that we are passing is 1 greater than what it should be. There is the bug. So we will now come out of this. Let's say continue. And let's close this GDD. File. Exit. Open the sample.c. And go to the line calling bubble sort. And change this argc to argc minus 1. Just save and close this. And now we'll compile this again. And now we'll try to run this again with the same arguments. And we are getting correct output. So this is how we identified bug using DDD and we corrected it. So we'll just quickly go through the slides to see some additional things we can do with DDD. So as we have seen, invoking, you can just give DDD and then open your file later. The other way that we used is DDD executable, and you can also attach DDD to the running program. You just have to give process ID and DDD will allow you to debug the running program. So the syntax for this is the last one, DDD program, and PID you have to specify. Okay, for quitting, as we already know, we are quite familiar with file and exit. You can also enter GDB on the prompt, quit on the GDB prompt. I'll just go to the DDD. for better demonstration. You have this GDB prompt here. You can also type quit here to get out of DDD. Other way is pressing Control Q. So we have to use hyphen G for compiling. Then you can start DDD first and open your file later using file open. So you can specify executable file there and you can debug it. Alternatively, if you can also give source file .c file and you can debug it. Now this is one interesting thing, looking up definition. DDD allows you to look for the definitions of functions. It allows you to browse through your code easily. So I have seen the call for bubble sort here and I want to locate where definition of it is in source. So just click on bubble sort and click on lookup and it will automatically navigate you to the definition of that function. Click on the function you want to search and click on lookup. Now stopping execution, as we have already seen, we can set breakpoints to stop execution. The other thing is watch points. We will not go through details of it, but as we had set a breakpoint on some instruction, you can also set a watch point on some variable so that whenever value of that variable changes, your program execution stops. So maybe you can set the watch point on some array element and whenever its value gets modified, your program execution stops and you can say where it is getting modified. So that is watch points. You can, if you have some problems like infinite loops or something, you will never get to the DDD terminal whenever you run it. So you can use escape there to stop execution. Program how to run, we have already seen. The execution window is the other thing. We have seen that the output appears here in GDB window. The other way to view is program run in execution window. And DDD will create a separate window for you and show output there. It just to see how your output looks like when your program is executing. Okay, examining data, as we already seen, there is something like value tips. I'll break on the main function again and I'll run this. I'll run it several steps. Okay, now you don't always have to create a data view or something to watch the variable. Simplest way is just take your cursor to the variable you want to see and it will show the contents. So argc is 5, it's showing. It will also show contents on the status line here, as you can see, argc equal to 5. So this is the simplest way to monitor your variable values. The other way is print. You can always print some variables on GDB prompt. Just type print and say argc, any variable you want to see value, and it will print the value for you. Other way is just click on it and there is a print tool available. It will show the value in GDB window. We have already seen how to examine stack using backtrace option. Then resuming execution, the next we already seen, it goes to the next execution line. Step also goes through the next execution line, but it allows you to debug through the functions. Next will go over the functions, it will directly execute function and go to the next line, but step will run through the function for you. Then until we already seen, then continue, continues execution normally from the current point, and kill. If you want to terminate your program abnormally, you can use kill. So I'm in the running context and I'm done with debugging, I can directly say kill. So the execution will stop there only. Now there is some interesting feature, undoing program execution. It's just like you do undo in your other editors or something, you can do undo in your debug. It doesn't actually go backwards through your program, but what it does is it saves the execution status of every line, and as you do undo, it will show the previously saved execution status. So you can go backwards in your program. It feels like you are running program backwards. So it is also useful sometimes. So that's all about GDB. You can always refer to the DDD manual for more details. Everything is given there in detail. That's it. Thanks.